AD. I'm Madeline Pett, and welcome to the set of Riverdale. Come in, I'll show you around. Oh, guess not everything is fake in here. Hi, welcome to Pops, the most probably iconic set we have on Riverdale. We all kind of end a lot of episodes here at that booth right over there, kind of relishing over what's happened in that episode or just drinking milkshakes. It feels like you can't really tell when our show is. Like, sometimes it feels like it's very modern because we've got iPhones, but then you come into this diner and it feels so like we're in the 50s all of a sudden. My favorite set pieces in here are actually the photos we have. We have a lot of photos of old crew members that just bring a lot of warmth and joy into my heart. It's really nice to see people who have brought this show to life for so long. Another favorite of mine at Pops is the giant Pop sign outside. I heard that when this diner was first built, a truck drove by and thought this was a real diner and pulled up and asked for food. He didn't get fed, unfortunately, because we had no food. It's all fake. I've never touched this till before. I've actually never been behind this counter before. That counter I've been behind, this counter I have not. We've got some very real forks. I'm sure these paper straws are real. We've got some bowling pins that feel real. So some of the stuff here is real, but this till, for instance, I need a key to open the drawer. All right, well, I can't open the drawer. This money's fake, I'm sure. We've got the iconic fizz fountain, which is what they call it on here. Doesn't work, not real. Hot chocolate, not real. Whoa, there's actually liquid in here. I think it's just colored water. I wonder how long it's been sitting in here. I'm sure we don't actually serve this to anyone in the scenes, but they're all filled. We also always have these pies in here. And now the first season I was convinced that these were real because it was my first TV show, but then I learned quickly that if you come up close, you'll see these are all very fake, but they look great from far away. And this is where Veronica stands a lot, right in this spot right here.
Whoa.
It's like, what texture is this? I'm trying to think of how to describe this to you. It reminds me of something. It's like a chew toy for a dog. I don't know what material that is, but that's the material. Also, there is real sugar on it though. So you could, you know, just lick the sugar off if you want. Any hoosers. A very interesting fact, I feel like, is that most of the time, because the cameras are set up in front of where the actual doorway is, we have to enter through a interesting back door. It's closer to where they set up the cast tent right outside, and so it makes it easier for us, less of a walk, and then also there's usually a bunch of lights and people in the way, so we find this a little bit easier. Come take a look. So here we are in this strange little kitchen set that I forgot we have back here, but I'm so happy I remembered in time. Sometimes they'll set up our cast area back here. I don't think this has ever been featured on the show. Does Pops even have a cook? I'm not even entirely certain. I guess Pop is the chef, I'm not sure. But there is some interesting little recipes on the wall that I just found as well. There is a potato leek soup recipe, and then there's also a pea soup recipe. So apparently we just serve soup at Pops. There's more recipes over here. Oh, we've got a little word of wisdom here. I feel that my destiny will never leave me. I am still that sad, sad girl with tons of fortune and a bag of tricks. You know? This is so bizarre. There's a really small little drawing of a dog over here as well. This is the real behind the scenes. This is a parking lot. Pops is in the middle of a parking lot. This is stage A, so we've got our craft services here. We've got a lot of the kind of central hubs of different departments in this particular stage. Should I break some of the magic for you guys? When you look out a window in a set, I'm sure this is for every show, this is like the street that's outside of the window. It's these giant backdrops, I guess. It looks so great on camera and in the show, but it's so funny when you see it in real life. Welcome. So it wouldn't be Riverdale without a walk and talk scene, which we shoot a lot of in the hallway. We have the girls slash boys restroom over there. Another fun fact, we only have like one restroom and one locker room, so we have to switch it between boys and girls a lot, which is why our set deck is so amazing. We have over here this stairway that leads to nowhere. You go up there and it's just a platform. I find that kind of interesting. This is a door that I believe leads to the other side. It's locked, but it leads to the other side of the bathroom right here just so that they can get the cameras in and out. Welcome to my locker. This is new. A lot of this wasn't in here last time, so I feel like somebody must have let them know we were shooting the inside. Sometimes, or there used to be a photo, it's probably where this was right here, a photo of my past brother, Jason. We've got our Vixen's practice schedule, which is always here. This photo of Vanessa, which is also always here. Oftentimes you'll find me here at the beginning of a scene, and then before the dialogue even starts, I've shut my locker and walked away. So you see like a split second of it. I don't know if they've ever shot an insert of my locker. Something very interesting, I keep saying that. This locker moves. Often. So depending on the shot and where we are in the scene, they can actually move my locker according to how they're shooting the scene and make it look like it's always in the same place. So it will always look the same to you, but I'll always be sitting in a different spot. It's just the sisterhood of the traveling lockers here in Riverdale. Welcome to the student lounge. This is also one of my favorite spaces. I feel like I'm gonna say that with every set. We have some of the best set designers and set decorators. I mean, it's just everything is so thought out. Most of my scenes happen on, you guessed it, this red couch right here. A lot of the time I'll end up on this couch with Tony, Vanessa Morgan. Now for in a group scene like I was the other day, Vanessa and I sat on that couch together, but it was over here. Archie and Veronica were over here, Kevin was over there. So it just depends on the day, the scene, who has the most dialogue. I think this is probably the most visually appealing couch to see on camera. So probably the person who has the most dialogue ends up on this couch. Now this is a set that we come to a lot to hang out in because the lights are always on in here and they never cover the furniture, which they sometimes do for other sets. So we can come in here and hang out, especially if we're shooting on the school at all. We'll just come and hang out in here and chill and have our crafty or our teas and just put our feet up in between sets. So this classroom is ever changing. Today it is the chemistry room, sometimes it is the physics room, sometimes it's the English room. It just kind of depends on what scene you have to shoot. This is the only classroom set we have on the show, which I also think is bizarre. Pretty typically it's that, and then sometimes it'll be, oh, I shouldn't say that, that's a spoiler. Sometimes it'll be something else that you'll find out later on. Ooh, that's exciting. You probably never see us in a class in Riverdale, and I couldn't tell you where my usual seat is in any classroom because I don't have a usual seat. However, I do remember that I think it was season two, I am dissecting a frog with Archie and we are sitting over here, but I'm very rarely in classrooms unless I'm just kind of placed there for a very quick scene. We don't do a lot of scenes in classrooms right now, which we all miss because we're gonna be leaving high school soon. All right, we can get out of here. I gotta show you guys my favorite spot. So that red light right there means that they're rolling. So we're gonna be a little bit more quiet over here, but come into my bedroom. Oh, they made it all up for me. Welcome to Cheryl's little slice of paradise. Oh, this is actually my favorite set. I think I've said that in every set, but I do really love this one. I feel like Set Deck did such a fantastic job of thinking of all the little details of Cheryl's life. My favorite piece in here is this bedspread. It looks like real roses. I don't know how they made it, and I actually asked Set Deck if they could find me one because I think it's just the cutest thing, and I believe they made it, which is absolutely bizarre. Meet Henry. This is my other favorite thing in here, this giant bear named Henry. I just named him while we've been here, but now it's going to stick for the rest of the season, so thanks for that, AD. Sometimes we'll be in here and we'll just cuddle him. There's some really cute photos of Vanessa and I cuddling this. Also, look, they put a little rose pin on him. How cute is that? I also have a very weird gummy bear chair right here that has never been featured but is always in here. Oh, the chandelier is fantastic too. There's a lot of great pieces in here. Anything rad, really. And over here is Cheryl's closet. This is where all of the magic doesn't happen. I don't think I've ever shot a scene in here. Maybe one with Vanessa where I was picking out a shirt for her or something to meet my mom, I think. They've got obviously all the right colors in here, but I don't believe there's anything I've ever worn in here. Actually, that's not true. I wore these shoes once while sitting by the pool, as one does. Madeline would never wear those. Madeline goes for comfort because Cheryl hurts Madeline's feet. So Madeline likes to just keep it low key. So that's basically it for this closet. We very rarely shoot inside of here. You just kind of see snippets. And since Cheryl came out of the closet, we're going to too. Welcome to the wardrobe truck. For those of you who don't know, we do our fittings inside of a wardrobe room where all of the costume designers hang out and they do all of our kind of big pieces. But they keep all of our costumes here on set in this truck. So I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of what that's like inside of here. May I come in, lovely? So welcome to the wardrobe truck. We never really come in here because they just bring the wardrobe to our trailer. But as you can tell, this is clearly the Cheryl section because it's all red. Lots of plaid right now, which I find very interesting as well in Cheryl's wardrobe. And a hell of a lot of pajamas. Cheryl's style is very different from my own. I typically wouldn't reach for a red and black outfit basically ever, which is funny because I'm wearing white and black right now. Anyways, but typically I won't reach for red in my day-to-day life. It's like wearing your work uniform when you're off, you know what I mean? Like red lipstick, I wouldn't really wear that either, although I do always have red nails. And then there's all these other people as well. I mean, there's Veronica, Hermione, Alice, all of the characters are in here. And then I think all of the day players up here too, like every character on the show is in this truck, which is crazy. I don't know how they keep it organized, but they keep it so organized. They do such a good job in here. It's crazy. I actually wore this outfit yesterday. This little number right here. Welcome to the hair and makeup trailer. After wardrobe, This is my next stop. This is where we spend probably a large amount of our time, especially mornings. We do a lot of really early mornings in here. Lots of coffee gets drank in here. This is where I sit. Welcome. Not like this. I never sit like this when I do my makeup, but this is my station. I typically do my own makeup, which makes it a little bit more fun and helps me wake up in the morning, which is fun. I took over doing my makeup probably halfway through season 3, and I think that's when I really would take this time to get into Cheryl's mood and her character. I'll look at what the scene is, I'll look at what I'm wearing, and how Cheryl's feeling in that particular moment and where her mind is at in those scenes, and I'll do her makeup accordingly these days, and I think that kind of lets me dial in a little bit more, even further than I used to dial in, which is really cool. Madeline's routine is so beyond different from Cheryl's, mostly because I wear a lot less makeup. Vanessa usually gets ready here, and then Cammy or Lily is over there. I spend about 45 minutes in the chair here, and then about 30 to 45 minutes down at the other end, all the way at the back right there. Here we are at Craft Services, one of my favorite places on set, to be honest. Tara, our Craft Services, is the best in the world, and she's so great with everybody's different food needs, and I just love it. Thanks, AD, for hanging out with me, but unfortunately, I gotta go do my job, so you guys are gonna have to get out of here, and I'm gonna have to get ready for work. Thank you.